49.5. What if we're going to get 50? Going to look at this one today. I might have that cover off, because what I want to do is, up there is the temperature sensor, which measures outside temperature. I've got three sensors on this one. One does outside, one does inside, and the other one's just inside the top of the panel. It's like a monitor, really, see what it's doing. But I think putting it there was a mistake. I'm going to put it on the side, because this is the north side of this building, so it'll be a more accurate outside temperature, because sometimes it can be quite hot, and I think it's because the sun's getting on that. It was a bit of a daft place to do it, but it was kind of an afterthought, putting the sensors on it. So I might have to take this off to get that cable out, and then we're going to extend it and put a little box on the outside to keep it out of harm's way. So this is the current location for that external sensor, and I think this is getting, because this wall can get quite hot, I think the heat's reflecting and then giving us an inaccurate reading, a higher reading than I suspected it is. But I think I glued this in here, so I'm not going to be able to pull that out, so I'm going to have to take this cover off. But I think it's a good idea to move that. Alright, that's the cover off. And you can see the tape's not parted company from that, so I'm going to have to put some new tape on there. Obviously got a little bit crispy in the sun, but that tape's probably not designed to be in the UV. It's got no UV protection, I'm guessing, but however. It's not too bad in here, really. It's the same as the other one. It's just a lot bigger. Bit of old tin roof. There's a lot of sawdust in there. It's the downside of it being in the workshop, but it's basically the same principle. Solar panel there. That's the intake behind that bit of tin, and then it's got a maze going up to, you can probably hear that, it's trying to turn, but it's not very bright out. It's early in the morning, so I've got to get this cable out, but I'll give that a clean up. All looks pretty good in there, and it's just like I say, it's just that tape. This is about 3 years old, this one, so give that a clean up and then get this sensor out. All right, I've already cut the cable, so we're past the point of no return. But this is literally just stuffed in the side. I'll put some glue or something like sealant. I'll have to fill that hole because I don't want anything getting in there. Bit of silicone maybe. I don't want to stretch this cable either. There we go, look. Whatever that was. Bit of foam. Right, silicone in that. And that's the panel sensor. I'll leave that one there. Give this a clean up, put that cover back on. I just popped it back on. It's not a one-handed job, but basically this is an 8x4 sheet, so it's quite big, and I'm on my own doing this. But I've got a couple of screw holes here, so all I do is lift it up, get this one in. I've got that corner one in. Now I'm going to do the other corners, then we know it's square, and then I should be able to just all loosely put the screws in, and then I'll go and tighten them up. So this is the sensor that I've just cut off. But obviously now it's in a different position. This is nowhere near long enough. It's about 3 meters too short. So I've got to extend it, and I've got this, apparently is the proper stuff for sensors. It's some sort of special cable. Don't ask me what it is. That's my brother's department. However, these are really, really tiny cables. I may regret doing this, because if you look at the size of these are going to be a bit of a nightmare. So my plan is to do quite a large joint, so there's a lot of copper touching copper, and then I'll heat shrink, put some heat shrink here, and hopefully that will do us. Prepping for this, I don't want this to be a soldering video, but I'll just show you what I'm doing. I'm putting a couple of different sizes of heat shrink on first, because these cables are different diameters. You can see that it's almost twice as wide, so ultimately the heat shrink that ends up on there is going to be way too big for this. So I put a couple of different sizes on, and hopefully should act as packers. There we go. That's what we're aiming for. Now I'm going to heat shrink that, and then I've got to do the same on the other end of this cable near the display. That's better. I put some silicone in the hole and around the back of this box, so don't get any muck in there. Pop these little thick covers in somehow. That's better. And then put the lid on, making sure it's the right way round, because that'll do my OCD, right? And that's the north side of this building now. Hopefully a bit more accurate, we'll see. 20 degrees inside, 17.3 outside. It's a more realistic temperature now we've moved that sensor. And the panel's currently at 42.2 degrees. And it's been raining most of today, so that's not bad. Half past five, but the sun's been out for about probably half an hour, maybe a little bit longer. And inside we're 20.9, 18.3 outside. Panel's currently 47 degrees. The fan's, I don't know if you can see it, the fan's roaring away there. It's actually climbing there. 49.2, it's over 120 degrees Fahrenheit. That's within, that's gone up in the last 5 minutes. So you can see how much sort of heat output you can get if you've got the sun on it, because the sun's quite low now, so it's hitting the big panel at a kind of a better angle. Obviously in the winter, that's the aim of the game, but yeah, 49.5. What if we're gonna get 50? 50.4. I think the thing to notice is the fan's running and the temperature's not going down, so it's not like it heats up, cools down, heats up, cools down. It's a fairly consistent heat. Once you've got the sun on it, obviously, you can get some big numbers out of these. And that fan's been powered by a solar panel. It's all free, which is great. So that's getting 51, over 51 degrees. That's an 8x4 panel. So theoretically, if you was to double or quadruple the size of that, you'd get a lot more volume of air going through it with a bigger fan and maybe a bigger solar panel, which would heat a bigger building. But it's actually raining and that's 51 degrees inside there. This is a couple of days later. That panel's just getting fully exposed to the sun. You see that shadow line? We're 5:45. So it's not had the full sun on it all day, or the full panel has not had sun on it all day. Let's go inside and check the numbers. 26.9 inside, 25.6 outside. The panel's 66.8 degrees. That's pretty good going. But yeah, that's a 66 degree free heat. I'll argue with that.